Hi everyone, join Vidi and myself to talk about a device update for Azure IoT Hub and the next IoT show. Hi everyone, welcome to the IoT show. Today we are going to talk about updating an IoT device using the device update for Azure IoT Hub. I'm excited to be joined here by Vidi. She's on the Edge Distribution Services team. Hey Vidi, it's great to see you.
Hey Pamela, it's super exciting to be here. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I'm super excited to deep dive into a device update for Azure IoT Hub. You know, as IoT continues to be adopted at increasing paces across multiple industries and use cases, it is super necessary for anyone building IoT solutions that includes operators, developers, customers, to have a way to really deploy these new features to meet their business cases. And I'm excited to have Vidi, you know, really share what we're doing in this space to address updating all these devices securely. Vidi, could you give a little bit more information about what is device update?
Yeah, definitely. Like you mentioned, to realize the full benefits of IoT's digital transformation, customers need a way to operate, maintain, and update their devices in a scalable manner. And device update for IoT Hub does just that by providing an end-to-end update solution that enables customers to manage and deploy updates to their IoT devices over the air. And this empowers them to respond rapidly to security threats and deploy new features to meet business requirements without the added costs of building and maintaining their own update solution. What we are doing is enabling the capability to ingest and distribute updates over the air, bringing the best of Windows Update that we've learned over the years, like scalability, security, and reliability, to IoT while optimizing it for IoT.
Could you dig into a little bit more on how you're leveraging the Windows updates and optimizing it for IoT?
Yeah, definitely. That's actually a great question. One of the key things that we wanted to do is bring the best of Windows Update, but still optimize it for IoT. A consistent feedback that we've had from customers is that these devices are in managed solutions where their uptime is so critical and the predictability around these devices is of the utmost importance. So what we do with device update is provide capabilities so that the customer is always in control of the updating process. Mm-hmm. And choose which devices get updated and when. And another key consideration that we've taken into account when designing device update for IoT Hub is that a lot of these IoT devices don't always have the most reliable of network connectivity. They could be deployed in the middle of the forest somewhere or in a mine, and you can't assume that they'll have reliable connectivity or have connectivity at all. So what a unique offering that device update brings is some of our optimizations around delivery, where we design for resilient downloads and even address the cases of disconnected devices through our unique on-network cache offering. We wanted to make sure that there's a large ecosystem of IoT devices, just like you mentioned. And we want as much as management and orchestration of these updates to be cloud controlled as possible, so that the agents that are running on these clients are super tiny and can scale down to the smallest of devices in the IoT ecosystem.
And I love that call out for disconnected devices. And I know we're going to have an upcoming IoT show in the future to dig into that more, because I know that's going to be a hot topic. It always is in the IoT space. And I would love to see this in action. Could you dig into the demo?
Yeah, let's go ahead and look at a quick demo of device update in action. You can look at the Azure portal here. So I have the device update capability already enabled in my IoT Hub. This solution is completely integrated on top of IoT Hub, so customers can easily get started with and integrated into any of their existing solutions. You can use the device update experience to publish updates, group devices, and deploy them over the air. And one of the key things is we provide this experience through Azure portal, but customers can also choose to build their own custom experience on top of our APIs. So I'm going to start off by importing an update. In addition to choosing the update files, I'm also going to the update metadata, the update manifest file. This includes information around the compatibility and the applicability information, and this allows device update to determine which update is the best suited for a given device. And then I can just go and select a storage container where I want these updates to be hosted and import the update. Usually it can take a couple minutes for the update to import successfully. And here we can see that the update has been imported successfully and is now ready to deploy. The next thing that I can do is take a look at my entire device environment, including all the devices that are over-the-air update capable. To take a look at this, you would have to group devices based on IoT Hub tags. Again, because of the integration of device update with IoT Hub, you can use these tags for other services also. And device update gives you at a glance view of all your devices that are compliant and secure with the latest update and your devices that are not. Here I can see that I have one device that's not on the latest update. That device update determines this based on the compatibility information that was provided as part of the imported update, as well as the device properties. With a simple click, you can create a deployment to go to your group of devices. Here you have all the control to select which devices get the update and when the update is applied to the devices. Once I've created the deployment, I can monitor all the active deployments that I have going on that are targeting different devices that are part of my ecosystem. Device update uses IoT plug and play to send and receive messages as well as properties from the devices to the cloud and vice versa.
So when you say the device update leverages plug and play or IoT plug and play, does that mean that customers need to make all of their components IoT plug and play enabled?
That's a good question. So no, we don't require customers to make all of their components plug and play enabled. We leverage for device update. Leverage IoT plug and play to discover and manage devices that are OTA capable. And then we also leverage plug and play interfaces to send and receive messages from the device. But we do not require customers to leverage plug and play for all of the other agents or components that they may have running on their device.
I'm wondering what device update supports. Does it support RTOS, Linux? What platforms can folks get started with?
Yeah, definitely. So with device update for IoT Hub, we have a whole range of devices that we support, right from the smallest sensors to your gateway class edge devices. We support directly connected devices, as well as devices that are in complex topologies where they're disconnected or nested on multiple levels. We have support for Linux and RTOS And all of our client agents are completely open source. So customers can take them and modify them for any configuration that they have running in their device ecosystem.
That's great. I love seeing that flexibility.
That's the plan. So now, while we've been talking, let's look at the device. It should have finished updating by now. So in the device update portal experience, you can also monitor the status of your deployments. Let's look at this deployment here. And yep, I can see that my device has successfully applied the update. And my device environment is now up to date using the new device update for IoT Hub feature.
That's great to see. Thank you so much for showing us a device update for Azure IoT Hub. You know, I'm excited to have people get started and play around with it. So I know your team, yourself, did a blog post that gives all of that information. So it sounds like people can go to aka.ms, IoT Hub device update blog. And so that should be right there for folks to check out. And thank you so much, Phoebe, for being here, giving us this preview view of the device update. And we're really excited to get our hands on it.
Yeah, I was super excited to do this today. Thank you so much for having me. And thank you, everybody out there, for watching.
Yes, thank you.